designers. I'm here to talk just briefly about our exercise to make use of the 25 design tips that we're looking at today. So to create a Canva Instagram post, I'm just open my Canva, and this is the size. I like the Instagram post because it plays nicely on all the social medias. It's great to start out on the Instagram platform and then push it out to Twitter and Facebook, and it has the same size that each of those formats use. So click on this size so that when you download, you will have the correct size. Okay, I started a project and I decided to use a journalism quote that is just so simple that it speaks to the heart of what we do. So John S. Knight was known for saying, "Get the truth and print it." It's actually at the Knight Foundation building on the wall. This is John S. Knight. He was an American newspaper publisher and an editor with a very storied career. He passed away in the 80s, but there's the John S. Knight Center that provides lots of journalism education and promotes good journalism in the world. So I admire him greatly, and so I decided to use one of his quotes. Okay, so here we go. He said, "Get the truth and print it." It's honestly that simple. It's so simple that you got to really think about what's being said here. Getting the truth is really hard. And as journalists, it's our job. We provide unpopular information that people don't want to get out. We get multiple sources on topics so that others understand all of the stakeholders and information involved in a topic. So getting the truth is really tricky, but it's our goal and it's our purpose and it's our responsibility to do that. Okay, so here's my saying, and I want to pull this together. Right now I've just got two typefaces, but I'm going to play around with these a little. I'll do it real quick. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to make my letter spacing a little tighter. Let's try right there. I'm going to leave my leading real loose right here. That's the line height, and see how I like this. I like this idea of a message below and then a different typeface above. I don't know. This is like super sweet, this Jonathan typeface, but it might be a little too cutesy for this message. So I'm going to go to the other handwriting fonts and maybe pick one that's not so decorative. How about Brittany? Yeah, no, that's still too decorative. That's easier to read. I'm okay with that. Can I make it even better? That's a little bit too heavy. Still too heavy. Oh, that's not bad. That is... I'm coming back here. I was there before, wasn't I? So, I like Moon Time because it's a little thicker and a little bit easier to read. One last check here. I'm going to go back up. I like that one. I really like that the best. Okay. So it's a very thin serif font with hooks on it, and it really plays off of the serif font in the back. So I'm going to move it up, kind of put it in the middle. I'm going to maybe just try to take that down, just like maybe 160. Okay, super simple. What I've done here, so let's talk about some of the techniques that I've used off of that article that I gave you. I have great use of white space. My text is centered. I could play around with it and pull it up. And oh, see how I got that line down the center. It told me it was centered. This is centered. I don't like that. I think I want to go back to pulling it right to the center here. Okay, here we go. It's what we do. We play and play and play. I'm also resting this on this baseline, the word and, so it has a path to follow. And I'm making sure that I have this in the center. Okay, so I think my reader will be attracted right to the center. There's some variance where the reader's going to be like, oh, okay, I'm drilling right in. What does that say underneath? Oh, get the truth and print it. Okay, the mood that I'm attending to is more of a serious note. Okay, it's not dreary, but it's not colorful because I'm talking about something serious about journalism. Okay, so I have white space. I have a minimum of fonts that I'm using. So I'm limiting my typeface. I'm using appropriate colors. My design is simple. I'm attending to my mood. So the thing about design is that good design is lots of things. It's not just a couple things, and you'll learn that. There's one thing that I'm missing. Elizabeth Sear didn't say this. John S. Knight said it. So I'm going to attribute that to him without hurting my design. John S. Knight. Okay. I might go up to 14 points on that. There we go. And then I have to decide where to put that. I think I might put it on the H. I think I'm going to take that down to 13. So it has the same width about as my H here. Because people will be drawn to it. That's called scale. This is big and this is small. So they both have dominance because of their size. Someone's going to go right in there and say, oh, what does that say? Oh, John S. Knight said that. Super cool. Okay, so I have my piece. I'm downloading it as a PNG, a high quality image. And I'm hitting download. It's downloading my piece. It should pop up in my tray down here. There we go. I'm just going to look at it before I post it. Come on. Always in a hurry. I'm always trying to push things too fast. Okay. Let's try opening it. Oh golly, this Mac gives me trouble sometimes. Oh, there it is. Okay, there's my piece that I can upload for the assignment. Oh my gosh, I hope you have fun. I love doing this stuff. Enjoy.